What's up again, guys?
Howdy.
Well, today we wanted to sit down and kind of talk about the process and why it took so long for our truck to get ready. A lot of people have been asking over the time that we shared that we were getting a new truck of why it's taking so long.
Right.
I think we originally shared that we were actually getting this new truck the end of September. So it's only been about 5 months since we actually shared, but the process has actually been taking since the beginning of last year, really.
Yeah. It's since the beginning, somewhere like January, February, I think it was. It's a process. Having a custom truck built is a process. Even when you have a fleet owner that's building you a new truck, you know, it's just a process. Now, it all really depends on how custom you're going.
Right, exactly.
You know, if you're not really going very custom, our last truck was really just a cookie cutter truck.
It was.
It was a custom sleeper and it had the big area and lots of amenities, but it's the cookie cutter truck of custom sleepers. So they're building those all the time. They have those on lots ready to be sold, you know. I mean,
as far as expediting straight trucks.
Expediting straight trucks, right. Now, when you're having a custom sleeper built and you're going full out custom, I mean, it's a process, you know. The great thing about it is, for instance, we were dealing with FIDA Freightliner. They handle everything for you.
Yeah. Let's kind of take you from start to finish of the process of building one of these trucks, what you have to go through.
First thing you got to do is find a dealership that, well, first you want to pick your truck.
What kind of truck
Volvo,
you want.
Volvo, Freightliner, Western Star, Peterbilt, whatever kind of truck you want. And then you got to find a dealership that actually builds Expediter trucks.
And knows what they're doing to build Expediter trucks.
Yeah, and knows what they're doing. Yeah, you don't want to just call up your local Freightliner or Kenworth and say, hey, I want to build an Expediter truck. And the guy's all, oh, I built one of those before. Yeah, let's do it. You know? You want one that they know what they're doing. That have been doing it for a while. For instance, with us, we dealt with FIDA Freightliner again.
Right, and that's who we dealt with on our last truck. So we had a relationship with them already.
Yep. So once you figure out the type of truck you want, you're basically going to find the dealership you want to work with. Then you're going to go in and spec the whole truck. You know, what part of the cab and chassis do you want specific to your needs? You know, do you want a truck with hood mirrors? Do you want the truck to have extra axle in the rear? Do you want lift axle, tandem axle? Do you want disc brakes, drum brakes? Do you want leather seats? Do you want cloth seats? You know, everything you would want to pick out in a truck. And for instance, with us, we were with FIDA Freightliner, who does Expediter trucks a lot. They handle everything for you. Mm-hmm. Once you finish speccing out the truck, then you go on to, well, what kind of sleeper do you want? How big of a sleeper do you want? Do you want an AA sleeper? Do you want a Bolt sleeper? Do you want an ARI sleeper? Do you want a PCS sleeper? You know, whatever sleeper you want. Then you want to figure out, well, what size box do I want? You know, and what kind of amenities do I want in the sleeper? Mm-hmm. And the cool thing is, FIDA Freightliner, they handle everything for you, but you're still part of the process.
Right.
So when the truck gets to the sleeper company, you work with the sleeper company and discuss colors and
options for the sleeper.
What do you want in it? And
yeah.
Do you want?
And so once you, before we go on to the sleeper part, once you spec the cab and chassis out and all of that, they have to order your truck.
Yeah.
Unless they just happen to have one luckily on the lot, which 9 times out of 10, they're not just ordering trucks to have on the lot like this.
They do have some,
yes. Yeah, they have some that they've already built sleeper and everything. So
when we were specking our M2 out, they had some on the lot, but none of them had disc brakes. We wanted disc brakes, so it had to be ordered.
So. Right. So once that process is completed and you've figure out everything you want specced out, they order the truck. Now that process, it can take months because they actually have to build your truck at the factory and deliver it to whatever dealership you're working with.
And I'm sure it probably takes a good 3 months. I know Freightliner's pumping them out.
Yeah, depending on how backlog they are, how many people are ordering trucks.
Yeah. Last year was a big year for trucks too.
Right. So
tons of trucks being ordered and bought last year. But they've dialed back this year, so it may be a little faster this year to order a custom. So
right.
it really all depends on how economy is doing too and how the market is. But. Mm-hmm.
And so once your truck is actually built, which again can take a few months. So depending on how the dealership works, how they do the process, a lot of times the truck will either, once it's built from the factory, it'll go back to the dealership and then onto the sleeper company, or it may go directly to the sleeper company is building your sleeper.
Yeah, we don't know.
It depends on the dealership, how their process works.
Yeah.
I believe with ours, the truck went to the dealership and then went to AA to have the sleeper built.
Yeah.
Now,
and then you got to wait for them to be able to, just because it's been delivered, don't mean they're going to get started on it right away. Right.
And usually while you're waiting on the process of the cabin chassis being built, you're working with the sleeper company, like Jason said, to pick out your colors, work with them on what design you want. We went with AA because they will do totally custom within reason of what they can do of how you want your sleeper built.
Plus, they're in the great state of Texas.
That's right. But, you know, a lot of them will do custom stuff for a price. You know, even Bolt will do some things. You know, you can pick out a lot of different things. But there's also, like with Bolt, you know, they have a lot of just a standard...
Floor plan,
right. Yeah, exactly. So it's not like you can move things around like we did with AA.
Yeah.
Every sleeper company has their own design process of what they can and can't do or willing to do and won't do.
Right.
So that process takes
a couple months.
Depending on how backlogged they are. Because the thing is, when you're ordering a truck, your truck is not the only truck that's going through this process. Yeah. I mean, they have fleet owners ordering trucks. They have owner
fleet
operators.
Multiple trucks.
Oh, yeah.
Some
multiple
of these guys
trucks
will
at a time.
Buy 10 trucks at a time and have them all sent to the sleeper company. You know?
Yeah. So it's not just your truck being worked on. Like we wish it was, and it would just, get it done. But
don't they know the crafties are getting a truck built? Come on now.
Right. So it could take a couple months at the sleeper company, they are building the shell, they're building everything out, you know, and like AA, it's not a big facility, you know.
Yeah,
that can take a couple months too. I think it took, how long did it take at the sleeper company for us? Like 2 months?
Two months.
It was about 2 months for them to build and put on our sleeper, you know, because they don't build it on the truck. Usually they build the shell, then they have to add it to the truck. They integrate it into the truck, depending on what kind of sleeper. I know ARI is not an integrated sleeper. It's kind of a bolt-on sleeper, right?
Kind of, yeah. They use a boot instead of an integrated, but...
Yeah, but that takes a while, you know, a couple months. It could take longer, depending on how busy they are and how many trucks they're working on. Because they aren't just doing expediter trucks either. These sleeper companies are doing tractor-trailer trucks. They're doing custom...
Oil-filled trucks.
Oh, yeah, it's not just expediting trucks.
Yeah, it's not just expediting trucks. I know we've seen oil-filled trucks at some of these places.
Oh, yeah. Tow trucks. We've seen tow trucks. Have sleep. I mean, all kinds of stuff. Hot shot trucks.
Yeah, hot shot trucks.
So that's a process, you know. And once it's done at the sleeper place, and this is just our experience. This is how our truck went. Once it was done at the sleeper place, then it is taken back up to FIDA. Then from FIDA, it went to the place where we had the box, the lift gate, the toolboxes all put on.
And they handle all the moving around of the truck for you. FIDA handles all that. They schedule it and take it over there and deliver it. For us, we had solar panels installed on the box. So that was another place it had to go to.
The generator had to go to a separate place.
The box company, they did the box and the toolboxes and stuff.
For our truck, the longest it sat somewhere waiting on something was at the box place.
And of course, it had the custom stuff that we had to get done to it.
Yes.
You know, so
that's the main reason it took so long is because our box, it's a 20-foot box. First of all, they didn't have a 20-foot box there.
Yeah.
To order the 20-foot box, it would have taken even longer. So what they did is they actually did something special to make the box for us.
They basically cut 2 feet off of a 22-footer and made it a 20-footer.
Mm-hmm.
And then they had to build into the separate compartment, build the doors on the side and all that. Hey, it was like, do we order it from Morgan as a 20-foot box, or do we have them cut down 2 feet off the box? Mm-hmm. You know, it was which is going to take longer. So that was one part of the process for us that took a little bit longer, you know?
Yeah, I think it was there at the box place for almost 3 months, right at 3 months. Yeah. They had it.
Yeah.
It sat there for probably over a month and a half before they even started fabricating our box, because they fabricate the box and then they put it on, and it's a process. And we trusted them to do it because that's all a lot. I mean, that's their specialty, is their boxes. Specialty. They know what they're doing.
Boxes, yeah.
They do a lot of Expediter trucks. They do a lot of other trucks. You know, again, our truck is not the only truck there that they have to work on.
Yeah,
so
their lot is,
it's,
they got,
oh my gosh, it's
out there.
It's crazy. And, you know, during this time too, the holidays, we had Christmas and New Year's, Thanksgiving. So that slows the process down.
Yeah.
But yeah, that's what took the longest, is the box. And, you know, if we would have just went in and said, hey, we're getting a 22 or 20 foot box, no, nothing special, it probably would have went a lot quicker.
Yeah.
But since we did want the special, you know, the separate compartment and all of that, that took longer. Then once they finished that, they still had to put on the lift gate.
the body place, that the box place,
yeah, does the lift gate.
They have to
put all the toolboxes on. Yeah.
They even installed the hazmat placards.
Yeah, yeah.
The flip ones and the regular slip-in ones. So.
And if you saw our truck tour, you saw us putting on more placards because we wanted another specialized flip placard. So we put those on ourselves, which we could have had them do that, but we did our own on the last truck, so we just opted to do that. Because every little thing you have done, of course, costs more,
takes longer.
Yeah.
So it, we held off on a lot of things that we'll probably just do ourselves, because the ceiling fans, you know, we've already replaced one. We got plans to replace the other. Mm-hmm. So.
And we could have had the sleeper company do that for us.
Yeah.
But again, it would have taken longer. It probably would have cost more than us doing it ourselves. We've already done it. You know, Jason is so handy and can do a lot of those stuff. And of course, he has a handy helper that always helps, you know. But a lot of the stuff, if you can do yourself, it'll save you a lot of money and a lot of time in the process of the truck build.
It will. And there's a lot of custom stuff that FIDA will get done for you, you know, that if you want dash cam systems or a camera system all around the truck, they'll do that for you. The options are endless of what FIDA can do for you. I don't know about most dealerships, but FIDA's been doing it a while, and they've had a lot of drivers come in and ask for some pretty crazy things, and they've figured out a way to get it done. So, they've made a lot of relationships with businesses out there to get dash cam systems put in, and or camera systems in the box, or whatever you're looking for.
Yeah, and it's nice that, you know, you can basically just tell them everything you want, and they take care of it from start to finish for you.
And they'll contact you here and there. Well, we can't do this, but they can make this work. Is that all right? Or, you know, it's a constant back and forth throughout the whole process too.
And this time we dealt with Neil FIDA there at FIDA Freightliner, and he was awesome. I mean, he helped us out along the way. I mean, when we went to pick up the truck, there was some issues. He got right on it, had them get right on it. I mean, he also helped with us selling our other truck. He just was amazing, and we've had nothing but great experiences there. Even when we bought our last truck, the sales guy we worked with is not there anymore. He's at Western Star, but we had a great experience when we bought that truck too.
It was funny. I was reading through the reviews of FIDA Freightliner, and there was one person in there that complained about the person that was in front of him in line at the parts because the guy couldn't speak English very well. The guy gave FIDA Freightliner a bad review because the guy in front of him couldn't speak English
holding
up the line. I'm like, really?
Yeah.
I mean, you know, no dealership is going to be perfect.
No, they all have their issues.
Yeah, and
you know,
I've really been pleased with the way FIDA has done their job.
Had no issues with them at all.
Not perfect, but they try to be.
Right.
I think that's the most important part when you're dealing with anything. At least they try, you know. That's been our experience twice.
Yeah. So. And any dealership you go to, you know, even to get any kind of warranty work or any kind of work done, you're going to have to sit and wait. I mean, we've been to FIDA and had to sit and wait. We've gone and got right in and out. And that's any dealership, you know. Yeah. Our main reason we wanted to talk about the process is because a lot of people just didn't understand why it was taking so long for the truck. And just to make people realize it's a process. And, you know, not just with like us being owner operators, but fleet owners. We've heard, you know, there's been people with fleet owners that, you know, the fleet owners getting them a new truck. Even when we drove for a fleet owner, you know, our fleet owner was getting us a new truck, and it was a process, and we had to wait.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of drivers, they don't understand, why is it taking so long? Why don't I have my new truck? I was supposed to get a new truck. Why?
Right. We've seen one of the other teams got a truck before them, and I know that happened when we were getting our truck. One of the other teams got their truck first, and it was just because ours was being held up.
Right. You know, it's a process. And
it is. It really is.
The main thing is how many trucks they're building and how, you know, backed up these places are. It's got to go to different places to get the different things. And like Jason said, the more custom you do, the more things you add on, it's going to take longer. I mean, to me, sure, it was a long wait, but it was definitely worth the wait. I would prefer them taking their time and doing the stuff right than for us to be calling, bugging them. And they're just like, let's just get it done and out. And they're quick.
You know,
it's worth the wait. Absolutely.
Start to finish, our truck took just under a year.
Yeah.
And it was a busy year last year. And I probably attribute most of it to that.
Yeah.
There were tons of people buying trucks last year, but then, you know, towards the end of the year here, you know, Freightliner's laid off some people, Peterbilt, Kenworth, PACCAR, or Volvo's laid off some people. So, you know, this year may be the year to buy a truck.
Maybe. Yeah.
It may go a little bit quicker.
Yeah. I mean, we've even talked to, you know, our friends that have had trucks built in the last few years, and even they've complained that theirs is taking a long time. It's not a quick process. It's not like you're just going in there and getting a truck that's already built. It's takes a while for sure. We wanted to touch on, because I know a lot of y'all thought we were going to go with the Western Star, and we love the Western Star we saw at the Expo last year. And honestly, we had already had this truck in the works when we saw the Western Star. Now, that doesn't mean we couldn't have scratched this truck and changed over to a Western Star.
When you do something like that, it will cost you a deposit, which is usually about $1,000. But
yeah, because when you order a truck, you do have to put a deposit down. Absolutely. Yeah. This truck was already in the works. We already had everything, you know, in the works for this truck. And I think, like we mentioned in the truck tour, the truck we were looking at the expo, if we would have still stayed with a 120-inch sleeper, we would have had an even shorter box, just because the hood length on that is longer. Can't be over 40 foot.
For those that don't know, you can't be over 40 foot.
Right, in a straight truck.
In a straight truck, you cannot go over 40 foot. So the measurement from here to the front bumper, you want to be the shortest possible to be able to get the most sleeper and box. So the Cascadia is 116 inches.
Ours with the DD13.
With the DD13. Yeah. The Western Star is 125 inches. So almost a whole, it's like 10 inches more. So, you know, that extra 10 inches, when you're limited to 40 foot, you really have to, you want to get the shortest truck possible. So you can get the biggest sleeper and biggest box possible.
Yeah, because everything's a compromise on the length of everything. Yeah, so,
but I did get a lot of cool ideas from that Western Star, like the
USB plugs we added.
The USB plugs up in the front dash that we added. You know, stuff like that. I love this Cascadia.
Oh gosh, we love it so much. Y'all are going to be hearing that for a while.
It's the same engine transmission in the Freightliner or the Western Star, so that's the most important. Plus, this Cascadia just looks so sleek.
Yeah,
the Western Star does too.
It does. That Western Star looked beefy at the Expo.
Yeah, but this Cascadia is pretty beefy too.
Yeah, we love it. We do love it. But you know, who knows what'll happen on a future truck? Maybe in the future.
If you guys are interested in building your own truck, we highly recommend FIDA.
Absolutely.
They were awesome to deal with.
Both times we dealt with them.
They're not perfect. You know, none of them are. Believe me, you're gonna hear complaints from all of them. You're gonna hear positives from all of them.
Yeah.
our best experience has been with FIDA, and we like dealing with them. So if you're interested in building a truck, be ready for a long process and give them a call.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, like Jen said, you know, be patient if you're ordering a truck or if your fleet owner is ordering you a truck, because it does take a while.
Yeah,
so.
Be patient.
But yeah, we just wanted to share the process we went through, why it took so long. A lot of people have asked. So yeah, hope that helped explain the process a little better for you guys to understand.
Kind of break it down there for you.
Yeah, absolutely. So thank you guys as always for watching and subscribing.
And until our next video.
Peace, love, and expediting.